ifakoyijaye television ifakoyijaye television gbangba la shanta awo kilumo oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye
back to his, will I say his formative, back to PDP. Without any cogent reason, without any telling us, because you know, you need to tell your supporters the reason why you are moving, not just any flimsy excuse. Because I probably because he had already known that the incumbent president will contest the second term, and which he knows that his chances are not, you understand. But that notwithstanding, having attained number two position
in this country.
Does he really owe anybody explanation why he's cross-cut?
He owes everybody.
Yes, he does.
They see it as a priority to always explain.
You see, that is another angle to this thing. These are politicians. They take
us for granted.
You must convince me this beyond
everything. And your followers.
No wonder most of them lose integrity.
Okay, let's go to Comrade Aishin. I'm coming to you, sir. Comrade Aishin, 1 minute.
Okay, you see, as my comrade have said, what we need to do and what we in particular as my party perspective, that we should put in place some institutional measures, either by the party or the National Assembly.
Okay.
If you are coming, you are cross-carpeting from one party to the other. I think you should kill. But because, you know, why you have these hindrances is this. Most of the parties, they need the money back. Are you getting it?
You are right.
They need someone that has the financial capability, financial strength to push them up. So when anybody, any big Tom and Harry, that's why you have corrupt cash. That you hide somewhere.
Corrupt cash.
Yes,
going up to somewhere. Not related.
Yes, you know, that you can spend anyhow. Because if it's your money that you labored for, you don't go and waste it. So, but you know that this man is coming down with his loot, they will definitely open the door for him or her.
That's like APC's tune to all the people that are coming down.
And by doing this,
This matter of man's version was curtailed. Was curtailed. So the danger of mass evasion or mass decamping is not the best for our democracy. Because by the time you don't have anybody attacking you, or not attacking you, another word, at least contesting or contesting you, you will do and undo. That is where the comparison between the military government and the democratically elected government now differ. Because the military government, no, they don't stand up and say, go and kill.
Sure.
And you have no, you don't have
no objection.
No. There is nothing you will do. Yeah. But if a democratically elected government, like what is happening in Nigeria today, you know our president, Buhari, Muhammad Buhari, has raised a lot of issues where this thing was contested. You can still remember the issue of Mabu.
Yes.
Mabu is still acting up to today.
Yes.
Because of Bara opposition. Mm-hmm. Don't let me tell you that Bara apostle command open and lose. Because people do not want that Mabu to be there.
Yes. For a purpose.
For a purpose.
For a reason.
For a reason.
And he's still there.
And you see there,
acting,
but there is
trying to summarize and tell you,
okay. There are certain things that said have been put in place not to make the his removal
possible.
To be something. Thank you very much. But I want you to know that the issue of this defection or the campaign is very dangerous to our democracy.
Thank you very much.
It's weakening the opposition.
And it's weakening the opposition, like my dear comrade Arowolo just said. Before we go for closing remarks, then, I have a question also that you addressed during the closing remarks. Let's go for a quick break. We'll be right back.
Have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? If you haven't, please log on to youtube.com and search for Ifakoja Television Blitz. Click the red button and please do not forget to thumb up. You can also connect with us on any of our social media platforms, website www.ifakojaetv.com, Twitter at ifakojaetv, Facebook ifakojaetv Lagos, Instagram ifakojaetv, email address ifakojaetelevision@gmail.com. My name is Mustapha Damola and I endorse Ifakojaetelevision. Ifakojaetelevision, the pride of the people.
Ifakoijaye television. Ifakoijaye television. Bangba la janta awoki lumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade okin ojo teye keye.
E ma wo Ifakoijaye television. Make sure you wo. E ma wo Ifakoijaye television. www.ifakoijaye.com. Thank you.
Ifakoijaye television.
Ifakoijaye TV. Keep watching, guys.
Bangba la janta awoki lumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade okin ojo teye keye.
Assalamu alaikum ya Hausa. Kuna kallon wani shirin da ake yi akan television Ifako Ijaye television. Shine kowa ke kallon yanzu. Malam Shehu shi ke kallo. Halaji Aruna shi ke kallo. Maman Kausara shi take kallo. Mama Aisha Ifako Ijaye television take kallo. Ku kalle Ifako Ijaye television akan yanan gizo www.ifakoijayetv.com.
My name is Akintande Oluwaseun and I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifakoijaye Television.
My name is Oluwafunmilayo Oluwole I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifakoijaye Television.
Oruko temi ni Sunday Oma Ladeniyi. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifakoijaye Television.
My name is Oluwafemi Sewagbe. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifakoijaye Television.
My name is Joseph Olusegun, aka Kodet. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifakoijaye Television.
My name is Yoda Odukoya. I'm proud of Ifakoijaye Television.
My name is Roland Odukoya. I am proud of Ifakoijaye Television.
I'm Dr. Samuel Mustapha. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifakoijaye Television.
Ifakoijaye Television, the pride of the people.
Ifakoijaye Television.
Welcome back, viewers at home. We are still on the program Politics and Perspectives. Before we went on a commercial break, I think Dr. Samuel wanted to ask a question.
Yes.
And don't let us still forget the topic.
We can't. What's the topic?
The topic is Nigerian politics and Spate of Decamping. Implications for Ekiti, July 14th election.
Okay. That question has to do with the implications for July 14th Ekiti gubernatorial elections. Okay. I want to start with Comrade Prince Taiwo. Okay. With this Spate of Decamping from PDP to either APC to EDP or SDP, don't you think it's putting pressure on the incumbent governor and your daily fellowship? Because there were many statements.
Was he really part of it?
We have a lot of statements credited to him, some of them verified, some of them are not verified, and especially to the candidate. Don't you think the chances of that PDP candidate win is getting slimmer? So that question is for you, it's for all the panelists.
Yeah, to be fair, I mean, with all emphasis, the essence of the recent campaign in Ekiti as a case study is just to weaken the power of the incumbent government in trying to.
Do you say it's weakened?
Yeah, it's weakening the institution. There's no doubt about that. In the sense that within your cabinet, if you have two commissioners defecting to another, it's sending wrong signal. Even if those commissioners don't have the electoral strength or value, in a situation where you have a House of Rep member, one individual, just going to the press and saying, look, I have decamped, is sending a wrong signal. Negative, which invariably shows that your house is not in order. You understand? So, because when you look at it invariably, you have to find out that how come now? The singular act of the former secretary to the PDP, Adeyeye, Prince Adeyeye, the singular act alone is a very big shock to the gubernatorial aspiration of Professor Bishola Eleka. You understand? So, politicians are just using this. Even if, what's his name, knows that he's not going to have any value for now. For the mere fact of saying, look, I'm no more with you, you understand? You know, so the implication is that they are just ganging up to weaken the whatever power strength or strength the ruling party has in the state.
Okay. And I want you to also make your closing remark at the same time.
Yeah. The only thing I'll just say is this. Whatever we do today, we might think we are fighting a particular candidate or interest. But we should all know that whatever we do today will definitely live beyond us.
For sure.
And the National Assembly, if we actually want this democracy, especially the localized political party to survive, we need to institutionalize our political parties. We need to have this kind of ideology. Before you join a political party, you should be ready. And the law should be made that, look, joining a political, though it is at will, but you joining or leaving the party should not be at will. You leaving the party could be at will, but leaving the party for another party should not be at will. There should be some stringent conditions before you can go to another party.
Okay. Thank you
very much. No, I don't. I think the question goes to the
okay, let's go to.
They need to run it up with our closing remarks.
Comrade Chief Samuel Arowolo, I love calling that Samuel.
was a special day. You know, Samuel, you remember how many times you called Samuel? Do you remember?
Yes, yes,
yes. Yes, so we are special. So now, Comrade Samuel Arowolo, Olushona, what do you see to the question I just asked, and what are your closing remarks?
Well, thank you very much, the moderator.
Yes, sir.
I want all of us here, and those our viewers at home, to know that going into politics is not to make yourself happy alone, but to make everybody happy. I don't want to be partisan. You can see that some governor in Nigeria like are doing what it is expected of them.
Okay.
I don't want to mention it. Don't see me as a
partisan.
Party person. I'm not a party person. Yes.
Maybe you used to be.
Yes. We should know that whatever we do today, it will outlive also. Yes. Whatever we do today will outlive also. We have just celebrated somebody who died almost for democracy. He did it. The man should have offered himself free so that things will go wrong and will not be necessarily subjected to restriction of freedom. But he died, but after 25 years, he was remembered.
Mm-hmm.
So those of you politicians, I am appealing to you that you should not be self-centered.
Mm-hmm.
Self-centeredness is the bane of politics in Nigeria.
Mm-hmm. Tell them.
Yes.
Come and tell them.
Please tell them that self-centeredness. And whether they are doing something, maybe they are constructing 50 kilometers, 50 meters road. They will now be putting sign up in the transmission.
And they will spend too much money
and the commission. Ah, they should hear God. Like one of our heads said, you should fear God. Please fear God.
There is God.
Okay. Nigerians are suffering. The mandate given to you to make people happy should not be. I mean, you should not be thrown into the trash.
Or utilize for your own personal
purpose.
Okay.
It's very painful. It's very painful.
Mm.
See, a politician who has no heart. I know one politician in our Lagos here. He was living in room and panel somewhere. But he has many mansions now.
I will not mention this.
He has mansions, both in here and the other side.
At the expense of the masses.
Thank you very
much. Comrade Chief Tunji, Onaolapo.
Yes.
Your answer to that question and your closing remarks.
Okay, our conclusiveness.
Mm-hmm.
The implication on Ekiti, right? You see, what I want to deposit is this. Those people that are cross-carpeting to other parties.
Yeah.
The implication for the present government of Ekiti now is that when they are in power, I think they are best of the same feathers. And because of some ideological difference, as at this present time, which I still believe that is selfish, because I don't think it's as a result of their interest. It's because of their own selfish interest. That was why we have this. And the implication is this. This might lead to the defeat of the incumbent.
But
the incoming government
should be
aware of what happened to this present government if at the end of the day it happens. Because why? At the end of the day, if it comes to power, that's I'm talking about firing, he should be able to put things right. So that, you know, there are times when if you are good for you to defect, look at when we have political of Lagos, you have Fashola. It's hard for anyone to hear of defection. Look, there might be
you cannot
hear where the deputy governor in Lagos with defects. A member of our country. It happens, I know.
That's why I said.
And the woman too.
Yes.
Do you know what happened to me? The only woman that has used it for two or three
But now,
you got deputy governor.
You know what?
But the woman did not become. She did not become.
Do you know what I said? Do you know what I
said? She did become. She did.
Kofo. Kofo.
Now, what I'm trying to say, what I'm trying to say, that I'm not saying.
Where's the patch?
I'm not saying that it does not happen. But it's not as rampant as what I have been now.
Okay. Thank you very much, Nigeria Comrade. You see, this Ekiti election discussion cannot end now.
Sure.
I have the opportunity of speaking, or let me say, communicating with Comrade Adeoye today and Comrade Ademola Olariwaju. They have agreed to come and appear on this program at least 2 weeks before the election so that we can do a thorough reappraisal. And intentionally, I invited them because I know they have sympathy towards PDP.
ADP.
But the ADP was PDP before. So I'm still, it's no more PDP.
He has become.
He has become.
But later they will now spring up and call themselves PDP under APC.
Okay. Now, viewers, we have told you our own perspectives. We may not be right. You have your own perspectives. Every one of us, we have our own perspectives. You can see that the four of us here, we are not even agreeing on any particular. Are we five?
We are five.
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I even so can myself. Okay, five of us, we have different perspectives. And that is normal. That is life. Don't force your own perspective on anybody. So you viewers, you have your own perspectives. I want to know your perspectives. And how do we know it? We have platforms. On our YouTube, what you need to do is log on to youtube.com. And when you get there, search for, in fact, the television blitz. And when you get there, you see one red button like this there, that says subscribe. Just click on it and you are with us and we are with you.
And also, if you want to watch us live, apart from watching us live, you want to know much about these, our beautiful TV station, you can check us on our website, www.ifakojaitv.com. I repeat, www.ifakojaitv.com.
Yes, and on Facebook, we have our Facebook account, and our Facebook account is ifakojaitv. Lagos.
And also, you can follow us on Twitter at Ifakojaye TV.
Instagram, Ifakojaye TV.
Send us your perspectives, mail us, send us your opinions, partner with us in every relocation. We are ready to partner with you as well. For our adverts, marketing, and all that, you can send your mail to ifakojayetelevision@gmail.com.
Okay, and in case you want to call us or you want to WhatsApp us, our number is 0805-196-4461. 0805-196-4461.
And also 0703-743-9891. 0703-743-9891.
And before we bid you goodbye, we need to really recognize those who are behind the camera, who have made it possible for you to see us, for us to communicate with you. I want to start with my dear comrade there, Siwanu Femi Peter. Siwanu Femi Peter, Emmanuel Aroboto, and
my wonderful black and shiny brother, thank you so much. The person of Samuel Faboye, you will not become white.
Until next program, not as next episode,
yeah.
On the next program, next episode, when we see you on politics and perspectives, on your one and only wonderful, with integrity, online television program, Ifako Ijaye Television.
The pride of the people.
Bye-bye.